Okay, Stacy, I haven't found the cost of the online course. Could you let me know? Yes, Stacy, the cost of the online course is on the registration, I think it's on the registration page, but typically there are $175 for the 6 or 5 week course, and that is it is a tutorial type of value because you're getting somebody else teaching it and marking your students' papers and making comments on the papers as well. So it is a tutorial value that we're charging. Let's see, do you have the parent courses on Saturdays? Andres, no, you know what? I have the parent courses on a Friday morning. Okay. If that's something that you need or have to have, then you could write me, and if there were enough people on a Saturday morning, or you can even watch the recorded online sessions as well. Heidi, with a girl, you're doing it with a grade 5 and a boy grade 10. Heidi, in that case, I would definitely do grades B and C. In that case, you don't want your girl competing with your boy. Your grade 10 boy does not need B. He needs... All right. Stacy, for someone just starting out with this program, am I correct in thinking that I would need either TWSS kit or SWI kit? My two girls are in grade 3 and 5 currently. You know, you can begin with just the TWSS if that's the way you like to learn and teach your girls, but I would suggest the A level with your girls, and because it is a girl in grade 3, I would suggest that they can begin that A level as well. So both your girls could be working together on the A level. You can order both, and there is a discount for ordering both, the TWSS along with a student writing intensive kit, or you could just order the SWIA. Deb, I'm going to be in Kitchener, Ontario next Saturday. Can I buy and use the coupon there, or do I have to order what I want before? You have to order what you want before, Claire. I'm so sorry. We have had people wanting to order ahead and then have us bring their savings, shipping, and handling, but we have now had to decide, we had to make a decision this year and just say, no, it's going to be first come, first serve at the conference. We can't do that. We are paying to ship it out there as well, so just because it's the cost situation, you're going to have to use the coupon here and place the order, and then it will send it out to you. I'm sorry, Clara. So you're going to maybe have to waive that coupon as opposed to being there in Kitchener first and getting it, getting the material and saving the shipping. So if you get to the conference and there is material there, you will save your shipping costs. However, if the material is sold out, then we're going to have to charge you $10 for shipping. So there you go. And I'm sorry that has to be done. It's just a matter of economy of scale. That's all it is now. All right, there was a question up here. For someone, suggestion team. As a first-time Academy participant this past year, they were definitely intense for my fifth-grade boy. Having this class today really laid it out simply. Would Webster's consider having a reluctant writer class available for beginners? Just a suggestion would be very encouraging for those new students. You know, team, we are working on that. We're working on, your reluctant boy there. We're working on changing that creative writing one to be a little bit slower, a little bit less material each week, so that those grade 4 or 5 students aren't so stressed out, and the parents as well, so stressed out. So thank you for that suggestion. We are working on creating that creative writing to be a little less. And I've talked with the teacher of that class as well, and there are ways that we can actually decrease the amount of workload and still continue on in the course even as it is. They just have to write one paragraph and we mark it, that type of thing. But thank you very much, team, for that feedback, because we have realized that for those younger students it is a little intense. But also remember, if you're signing up for these classes, and I'm not describing your comment there, team, but that that if you're going to sign up for a 5 week course, to make sure that you set aside enough time. And again, I'm not discrediting the fact that these new students and our reluctant writers will find it intense, and that we are adjusting for that. Let's see, Jennifer, thank you for the workshop. Good to review. You're welcome, Jennifer. Heidi, can you touch on the history-based writing lessons and what levels they're intended for? Okay, there are some theme-based writing lessons, and one of them would be the ancient history writing lessons. And what I would use these for is you could use them as I would do a student writing intensive first, and then I would use a theme based after. So I would use it alongside the student writing, but I would first go through the whole student writing and then use the theme based as a follow up the next year. There's not as much teaching in the actual theme based workbooks or writing lessons. But they do go through all the 9 units in the book. You could use, you know, you could go through the student writing intensive 1 year and then follow it up with a theme-based writing the next year, and use your DVDs as backup teaching, okay? The ancient history-based writing lessons are geared for more of that grade 4 or 5. The medieval history lesson plans, theme-based plans, are geared for more of the upper elementary, junior high, because of the content, the source content. The life science-based writing lessons would definitely be junior high, high school. Now, we have some that are called All Things Fun and Fascinating. I would use that with a grade 2, and it is very nice and basic, easy content to use. The All Things Fun and Fascinating goes very slowly, and it would be an excellent beginning program for your grade 2s and 3s. There's another one called Fables, Myths, and Fairy Tales, and that's one that also you could use for your younger grades. A lot of practice with Unit 3, writing stories. But I would encourage you to begin with a other than that grade 2 one for All Things Fun and Fascinating, I would encourage you to begin with a student writing intensive or at their level first and then follow it up with a theme-based. Stacy, can we use those? Would we need 2 student writing intensive workbooks, or can girls share or photocopy? They weren't meant to be photocopied. They are meant to be written in, and it does say no photocopying, but you can use it. I mean, I know families use it they have one workbook and then the students write on paper beside it, so that you're using it for both students. I think you would find that it's valuable to have each student use one, so that you can build up a portfolio of their own work right in that workbook. But that is up to you, definitely, depending on how your girls like to work. Would they work together well with using it as one? We do also have, for those of you who have older students, an excellent resource is our How to Write Excellent Essays in 7 Easy Steps. This was written by Dr. Webster and in conjunction with my husband, and they have put together this brilliant little resource book that teaches how to do the essay writing. And I'm going to try to bring this as close as possible so you can read. It has actually, do you see those? kind of funny to do that on the computer here. But anyway, it lays out the basic paragraph model, then it shows the basic essay model, the extended essay model, the literary expository essay model, persuasive essay model, argumentative essay model, super essay model, and then citations for essays, and it works out. Yes, Heidi, is it not on the order form? Yes, it is on the order form. It might be under the advanced. It is $44.95. It